Tonight, CBS 5 Investigates exposes some frightening facts about serial rapists. There are a lot of them out there in our community.
And most of them will never get caught. Now, Chief Investigative Reporter Morgan Lowe tells us how a new approach to DNA testing may be making a difference.
These are the faces of accused and convicted rapists.
She got in the vehicle believing that everything was normal.
According to police, they've each targeted multiple victims.
Our profile matched a profile in a case out of Phoenix.
And our investigation shows there are more of these serial predators out there than authorities previously thought there were.
Perpetrators are doing this not just to one victim, but to multiple victims over time.
A recent study by Case Western Reserve University looked at 20 years worth of crime data and found that 51%, or more than half of the rapes, were committed by serial offenders, and that it is likely that a sex offender has either previously sexually assaulted or will offend again in the future. Take Abbas Shemesawi of Phoenix. Police believe he used his cab to target at least two victims. Nathan Loeb of Tucson was convicted of raping seven women over 12 years. And Christopher Van Buskirk of Goodyear was arrested last week and charged with six rapes. The key to catching these men? DNA profiles from unsolved rape kits. They're now being compared to other unsolved rape kits.
How much of a tool, how much of a benefit has that been?
That's allowing us to find and identify certain perpetrators who have been doing this to person after person without justice.
Tasha Menaker is the co-chief executive officer of the Arizona Coalition to End Sexual and Domestic Violence. She says we're still just scratching the surface because as many as 90% of sexual assault victims do not come forward.
And that's because victims are afraid that they're going to be blamed for their behavior. They may not be believed.
Personally, I have had to redefine justice for myself.
Jacqueline Hennick was a student at the University of Arizona when she was assaulted by members of the football team.
I initially thought it must just be me. You know, I'll just get over it. I'll just try and forget about it. But then I found out that this was a pattern, that they were doing this multiple times in a very similar way.
Her attackers were identified and disciplined through the school, but never prosecuted. It is estimated that only 2% of rapes result in a conviction. So while these recent arrests may seem like progress, in a vast majority of cases, even with serial rapists, there is no criminal justice in the end.
It's extremely disappointing for us when we're working with someone who wanted to see their perpetrator go to prison or experience some form of criminal justice response and justice in that form, and they don't see it. That's very difficult.
Something else that came out of that Cleveland study is that these serial sex offenders don't have any one specific type of victim that they target or manner in which they commit the crimes. They base their attacks on opportunity. Mm.
Crimes of opportunity. Okay, we know you have done a lot of research on this. So in your research, did you find any local police departments who have the DNA profile of a serial rapist but don't know who that person is?
Yes, they know there's at least one of them out there in our community right now. They've identified, they've linked them to different crimes. They don't know who this person is. Likely there are going to be more of them as they continue to test and compare these DNA rape kits.
All right, Morgan Lowe, our chief investigative reporter, thank you.